Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Rhino Exploration. Today, we are going to be installing the KC rock lights underneath the Jeep. Those right there. So we're gonna be working out here in the parking garage again. It'll be loud. I'm gonna try and talk as loudly as I can without bringing too much disturbance to the peace of the parking garage. But I'm gonna bring you guys along the journey as we start to install these. I already know how I wanna lay them out. Or they're gonna go under the Jeep. We just need to get them installed, run the wires, and then hook them up. We gotta do some changing under the hood of the Jeep. Once we get all that done, we'll be gold, and then we'll see if we can get some lights lit up under the Jeep. So stay tuned, guys. Hey guys, good morning. So we're going to unbox these KC HILITES rock lights for the Jeep. We're gonna see what's all in the box, take a look at all the products, and then we can start to figure out how we want to stick them up under the Jeep and do all the wiring. So let's get started. So some of the fun joys of not having a garage or an actual like workspace to work on vehicles is I get to do things in the office, sitting on the floor, unpackaging things because there's just not enough room to do it on a table. So we're gonna first open up this. It is the connector that all of this wiring that connects to the KC lights themselves. All run into this, which then this will run into the aux beam switch panel that I have in the Jeep. That's pretty cool. Got the fuses right up in here. This is where all those connectors will connect to for all the lights, which seems to be pretty straightforward. Doesn't look like there will be much of an issue. Oh, here we go. It's able to pull it off. And here's all those fuses that run for all six of the lights. There we go. Camera's fighting me a little bit, but there we go. Pop this cover back on so I don't lose parts. And this looks to be like a very pretty good wiring harness. Looks like we have positive, negative, and a ground wire that all can connect to. Yep, and here's some splits. I feel like they give you several different things to connect for this. But let's let curiosity kill the cat a little bit, metaphorically speaking, and open this up because I want to know what's in it. So, very long wiring harness with different ends. They go to various things. We have one running from the fuse, negative. Almighty positive is over here. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I'm gonna straighten this up real quick and then we'll look at some of the other stuff. So, instructions. What's really cool about these instructions is it actually gives you a diagram on the back about what it should look like or what everything from that big wiring harness I just showed you connects to. So, this will be very helpful. I like instructions. So digging in that bag, this bag that's now empty, that housed everything else, we have some zip ties that have these little holes to run the wires through, which is actually pretty cool. Never actually seen this kind of zip tie before. covers for the wires to protect them, keep them kind of weatherproof, cleaned up, make it look nice in the Jeep. So that's super helpful. More zip ties. Mounting brackets. Brackets to help hook these onto the Jeep and then hook the light onto it so that they can hang down. Also probably some mounting bracket for the fuse block here. Going to be very, very helpful. I'm excited. And then a new KC Highlight sticker. I lost my old one when my back windshield or the rear window on the Jeep was smashed. So it'll be nice to be able to put this back on. Bolts, screws, more connectors, and then all these wiring harnesses. Got six of them for that run from the light itself to that fuse block. And then all the lights. So as I said, guys, I'm working in the parking garage. So this is my workbench today. I got my toolbox. I dropped the seats of the Jeep down so that I could put the toolbox here. I got the lights over there. I got some water, camera bag, the tool chest that's typically in the Jeep already. So all this stuff is out here. I also got my cart with some other tools within that box. So this is our setup for the day. It's not terrible, but one day a garage will be nice. Alright guys, so we're going to pull out the KC lights here in just a second. We're going to pull them out. We're going to get them kind of laid out where I got all the tools and bits that came with the kit, so I can get it all lined up to where I want it, and then I'm going to start installing it under the Jeep to where I want, and I will take you guys and kind of show you where I'm going to place them and get those bolts loose and stuff like that. So let's pull out these lights. Alright guys, so we got everything laid out here. We got the lights here. These are the brackets that come with the kit. We have the bolts that are to help hold the light to the bracket. We have the connector piece where all the lights will plug into, and then this will run to the switch panel. And then in the kit, KC provides you with three different lengths of lights. You get a 5 meter, that's another 5 meter, this is a 3.5 meter, and a 2.5 meter. So obviously front of the Jeep, middle of the Jeep, back of the Jeep, and they should all be able to run and reach the connector here. So we got them laid out. I'm going to start getting the lights hooked up to the brackets, and then we're going to start getting under the Jeep. Alright guys, so for this we need a 13 millimeter socket, because that is what fits the bolts that came with the kit. Alright guys, as you can see, we have got them on their brackets. Sorry, I'm fighting with some extra light here to help us see. But if you can see, alright guys, as you can see, we got them on their brackets. So now we're going to get under the Jeep and start placing. Alright guys, so here under the back fender, or yeah, the back bumper of the Jeep, we're gonna hang the first light off of this bracket right here. This is one that connects part of the steel bumper to the Jeep. So we're actually gonna undo this bolt, slide the piece on the bracket, and then we're going to rebolt it on using all that same voltage right there.
And for this bolt in particular, we need a 5/18, or a 5/8, sorry, a 5/8 bolt. So we're gonna break that loose. I'll be honest, that bolt was a little disturbingly loose. And just like that, guys, we got it off. So let's go get that first bracket.
So for this one, we are going to use the L-shaped bracket because it'll hang nicely right off of that bolt, and then the light will be directed downward here at the back of the Jeep. I wanted to put two back here because then it'll provide plenty of light back here on the back end of the Jeep. So if I ever hit the bumper down low, or if I'm just at camp and I need to just light up the back so I can see, I can do it that way. One day I want to mount some lights in other places, but for now this is where I'm going to put it. I can always move this light later on.
Pick it. So that'll be kind of just loosely. That's mocked in there. I don't have it tightened all the way down. I can easily loosen this bolt to move the light a little bit. But that's the first one in there. It's kind of what it looks like from the bottom. So we're going to go install the one right down over there on the next side of it, and then we will start doing the rest on this side.
All right, guys, two down. We got four more to go. We're going to start working on the driver's side of the Jeep underneath it. We're going to take these two and we're going to go get them put in place and then like loosely mocked up in place. And then we will do the passenger side, get them loosely mocked up, and then we'll start running all the wiring. That's going to take the longest. The bolts on that side, it's a 13 millimeter. I'm going to use the long bolt and the extension just so I have some room with my hands to play with it.
So for this light, we're going to stick it right under, this is the passenger the driver's side rear door. And we're gonna go right off of this rock slider bolt here so that the light will be tucked up here and won't get smashed by rocks. As you know, the chance of it'll be less because we'll have the rock slider here and it will not be at the same level as the rock slider. So that's the whole purpose of using these ones here today. There we go, guys. Light number three installed, but first one on the driver's side over here. So now we're going to go up under, we're going to go right up down there, up under the driver's side door, and install the next light. Okay, guys, point of reference. Not quite under the driver's side door, but right up here in this pillar, we're going to use this bolt here. This is the last bolt that holds on the rock slider. So we're going to unscrew this bolt and get the light installed there. Alright guys, the fourth one's in. Let's go to the passenger side and do those two over there. Alright guys, so I did film parts on the passenger side. It is the exact same as the driver's side. So I decided to speed up the film here a little bit, but it is the exact same spots on the passenger side as it was on the driver's side.
The last light to install onto the Jeep. Passenger side rear door. Last bolt on the rock slider. That's where we're gonna put it, guys. So we got all six lights roughly installed. They're where I want them to be. They're not bolted all the way down yet. I'm leaving them loose. So now we're gonna start on the wiring and plugging them up, running the wire to where I need it to go, and then seeing what kind of like length we have to play with. Update.
So I have gotten all the lights put on. They're still not tightened up all the way yet, but I have it all wired, or I should say, I have all the wiring running through the Jeep the way I want it to, up to the engine bay. Now I gotta mount the other thing, mount the little circuit here. Gotta mount this so I can then have it all connect to it, and then I'll connect it to the switch panel. Yes, switch panel. So what I'm going to do though is I'm going to show you guys how I kind of routed it real quick, because I didn't film it. It took 3 hours. It's little by little, but I'm going to show you guys what I did. So you'll remember, we put this light in, and so I ran all the wiring from the back and this light through the chassis itself. Ran it up through this, all the way down. And I ran this wire into here. I had it all pop out right here, and I ran it up behind the fender into the engine bay. And here are those wires, and I did the same thing on the other side. So now that we have all those up there, which to do that, I used a lot of masking tape and the old Jeep antenna. Yeah, I used the Jeep antenna. I replaced mine, the one that's on the Jeep now. Like, I replaced it with that one 6 months ago. That's been sitting in my closet. I'm glad it was sitting in my closet because it came in really good handy. But right now, this is what we have left. This, hook it up, get everything wired to it, wire it to the switch, button down everything, turn it on, see if we got light. Okay guys, so once I got under the hood, it was a bit of work. I'm going to be straightforward with you. I had to do some rewiring, which when I installed the aux beam switch panel into the Jeep, and when I installed the terminal for where all the switches would be installed underneath the hood, I had an idea in mind that I'd have to rewire it and move it to a different location altogether. Just because of where it was sitting, it just probably would not have sufficed. And after staring at this for about a good 20 minutes, planning out how I wanted to route all the wiring and finding the spots in which it would fit underneath the hood, I decided to take everything off of where it was located, which it was on top of the fuse box at the time, and I removed it all from there. Because I have a spare fuse box cover, I wasn't afraid when I installed the aux beam switch panel to put it on top of there for the time being. So I ended up putting the terminal for all the switch connectors right up under the hood, and you'll see it here shortly. But through this process, I had to unwire everything that I had done up, and just I took it slowly. I didn't try and rush the process at all. I wanted to make sure that I had thought it through. I had several different ideas, and I mocked up few of the different ideas that I had and just found that it wasn't going to work. And so when I found the setup that was going to work, I started to do more deconstructing of the parts and then sticking it where I wanted it to be, and it turned out really well.
Shocking each other now. Chill. Sit up under here. Don't shock them. Go in here, stay. You get to just hang out like that. Sit. Stay. Don't move.
So as I mentioned, I thought about this for a while. I had been in the garage for going on 4 hours now, and the last 2 hours of this whole project was working under the hood. As you can see, I was trying to figure out where I wanted to place it. I eventually stuck it up higher, but the aux beam kits have not been developed yet for the JL style of the Wrangler. They're all meant for JK, so doing this, I had to do a little bit of fabricating to the actual stand that the terminal sits on, but I did a lot of rearranging to see where it might fit and what would work the best and be functional. I wanted it to be up out of the way, but still I was able to put the wires up into it and ensure that everything would just connect smoothly, look clean, and I eventually did find that. Alright guys, so we have now moved the aux beam switch panel. We have put in the negative terminal piece for the KC lights. We have installed the positive connectors for all the KC lights. And now everything will reach these perfectly. And then I can put my replacement fuse box cap on. But yeah, took some thinking, but we figured it out. So we're gonna continue the work on this and get everything wired up. So during this, this is the terminal for the rock lights that all the wires will run into, and then you can run this to the terminal for the aux beam switch panel that's connected inside the Jeep. So during this, I just went driver's side to passenger side furthest away, so the 5 meter wire kit that was at the very back of the Jeep all the way to the front, and just got them all wired up in there. And then I ran the main wires from this terminal to the switch terminal, hoping this is all making sense. So this is that negative that all the negative wires hook up to, and then it runs to the terminal for the aux beam switch panel. So all the positive wires got hooked into that little terminal that you just saw, and all the negative wires get stuck on top of here. So they are all congregated in one spot. And they actually fit really well. It actually cleans up really nicely once it's all on there. It kind of feels like a bit of a mess, but once it's on there and you screw it down, you're able to manipulate the wires just enough that you can get them looking pretty clean. Stages of all of the wiring process under the hood was I wanted to make it look clean. I didn't want it to just be a bunch of jumbled up wires everywhere. So I took some of these wire sleeves that I had had from previous projects and used it to wrap up all the wires on each side of the Jeep, so the passenger and the driver's side, and then I zip tied them to parts to some of the metal areas underneath the hood so that they stay in place. They're not going to bounce around until I can get a more permanent solution to stick them up under the hood. But for now, they are all cleaned up. It looks really, really nice, and they're just up out of the way. So this is where I was plugging in the rock light wires into the aux beam switch terminal that then runs into the switch panel inside the Jeep. So these were both the positive and negatives. They see positives go on one side, then the negative. Once I got those all hooked up, we were then able to see if we had any kind of result. Alright guys, so we finished. We have everything reconnected, the battery's all reconnected. We got all this nicely coned up, zip tied in place, all these are there, all that. I got it all connected under here with this aux beam. She's all nice and connected in her new spot. That's all connected right there. The wires are run really nicely. I didn't trim up the wires. I just kind of zip tied them all for now. I'll eventually trim them up, but that's all done. Big question is, do we have light? Let's find out. All right. Turn on the power. All the power. Okay. Switches are on. Let's find out. We have power. All right guys, I am so happy that this came out and that it all works. It's all on. I can't wait to see what it looks like later on this evening when it gets dark. So thanks for joining me out here in the parking garage, and I'll catch y'all next time. Thanks for watching. It there. Those are the only things that should be there. If I go like this, put that there. I put that there. I have to take this, run it up, and I need to attach it to the side of this thing, which is just a cover, which I don't want to because that's a lot of heat generating off here, which that's plastic. I could flip under there. You know, it pops up, runs under. Which I could do that. Sit. Don't touch metal. But if this was tapped down, I'd be able to get this off as much. Because this isn't even sitting down where it would be. So let's find out. First off. First, never so foremost, let's put this back on.